Hey, in this video, we're unboxing and discussing the Moon Shade portable awning. I got a discount code for 30 bucks off in the description if you're interested in this afterwards. It is the Rolls-Royce portable awning. Hey, if you're interested in this kind of content, go ahead and click that like button. Don't forget to hit subscribe and click that bell to be notified when we got new videos available. Let's go ahead and get started. This is Robert from Sherburn Outdoors. Hey, today I'm very excited to be talking about the Moon Shade portable awning. As you guys know, I've been looking around for a portable awning for quite some time. I looked at the 270s. My current setup, which I'll go through in just a second, really doesn't work for that. Although those are really nice, they're very expensive. I needed something that worked for my setup with a low profile Billy Bars rack on a Jeep Gladiator. As you can see in these pictures right here, I like to keep the tent, which is behind me when it's collapsed, behind the cab. And so looking around, I actually ran across this at Matt from Ozark Overland Adventures. Moon is a big sponsor of his, and I reached out to Moon, and we partnered up. And so now I'd like to introduce you guys to the Moon Shade portable awning. This weighs about 8 pounds. It's not very heavy, but it's extremely heavy duty. And it is so simple to set up. Again, very compact, heavy duty, but not heavy. So let's open this up and take a look. So it's got a very nice bag. It's easy to put into. It's not like some of the other bags where you stuff it in here and you try to really zip it up. It's really, really nice. Let's just pull everything out. So first things, it comes with the awning itself. It has the poles that go along with it. And they come with a nice Velcro piece to hold them all together. Let's pull out the Moon Shade, which is the most important piece. And then we got a bag with stakes and guidelines in it. Everything is just such high quality. Very impressed, but this Moon Shade is just such high quality. Look at this when we come in here at all the stitching that comes inside of here. You got the slot to hold things in, you got additional, and behind it you've got carabiners to connect to the poles. Let's go ahead and lay this out. Just get it out. Now this is a 7x9, so I'm gonna have the 7-foot side going against the Jeep Gladiator right here. So we've got it set up here. It's relatively simple. Kind of got it laid down. First thing we also want to do, maybe not step on it, but open up our poles. Let's get our first pole that we're going to use. So, unlike other vehicles that have big high racks on the Gladiators, I don't have that. I've got the Billy Bars rack, and it's very low profile. So, 10 is low, everything's low. So, but because that is here, I can actually take this and run this through the Billy Bars rack out the other side. And now I've got my attachment point right here, nice and simple. We'll run this to the other side. Everything's underneath the tent, so we don't have any issues with anything, actually. Tighten that in like so. So now our first piece is up. Next piece is, let's get some poles. Put in the top. So these are really good. This is your basic tent pole that you've been using your entire life, except much higher quality. These go together really simple. And then you put them in the holster right here. And then you just bring them over and you put them in the opposite holster on the other side. In this particular case, right here. So we'll go here. We'll do the exact same thing for both sides. Put it into the slot. Bring it across. And so just like that. And now the next thing is to take these clips right here and start hooking them in to our shade. And it's that simple. So far we've got this set up. Now it's time to raise it up. So next thing is, let's put our next set of poles in, which is going to be our legs. And these are telescopic ones. So we'll put them in like so. These have something to attach to the carabiner. I mean, look at that detail. Not that this should be out in a windstorm, but this is, you know, very high quality. Go ahead and pop this one up. put it in place. All right, there's one. It's not the height I want it yet, but we'll get to that. All right, let's do the exact same thing on the other side. Go ahead and we'll clip in our carabiners here. We're gonna raise this up a little bit because I want it to go just a little bit higher. And that is as easy as reaching down here, pushing this in and pulling. It goes up to the next spot. We're gonna go up two. That's where I wanna be. We'll do that on both sides. Now this is great because I am a little uneven. So this high side here really is not gonna need two, it's just gonna need the one. So we'll push it in and go up to our next side. And now we are gold. So now we've got the Moon Shade portable awning deployed. This thing is absolutely awesome. Again, it's 7x9. Right now I've got the 7-foot side hooked up to the back of the Gladiator. I do have it pushed off at an angle because we are down in this ditch here a little bit, and it gives me some capabilities to move it around with the telescopic legs. Very, very flexible. This thing is just awesome. I don't normally get this excited about camping products, but this thing is a big deal. And let me tell you why. So again, if we look at how the Gladiator's set up here, you know, I do use a low profile bed rail system here. I don't have the high one where I could have an awning at the very way up high like this, and the rooftop tent even higher. I like things low because you see this picture right here, everything sits behind the cab when I'm traveling. But you know, that has some inherent problems. If I want to hook an awning to here, you know, it's only like, you know, it's like 4.5 feet high. If I want to hook it up on top of the Gladiator, you know what, that's great on this side, but you know, all my stuff's happening back here. I do all my cooking on the tailgate. Everything happens in my particular campsite in the back of my truck. So in this particular case, you can see here how I've got this latched in, is I just have it going straight through the Billy Bar's rail system. It's actually ingenious. And with that, you can see we got our main pole coming through here, goes into here, and then this is where these go into these particular slots right here and gives it all the strength. In this case, it goes right underneath here. Don't have to worry about any type of wetness, dampness. Nothing's coming down. Not that it was going to come in anyway. So if you don't have the luxury of having a setup like me, or you don't have different types of T-track that you can put latches in to get your particular hooks in place to put a moon awning, that, don't worry about it. They have you covered. They sent me a suction cup latch so that I can latch my pole to this directly at a big one that'll go on a particular roof. We're going to use this on our Grand Cherokee for going to UGA games, Go Dawgs. They sent me another one that's got these suction cups on here. Actually, they're very small. And then if you look right here on their website, they've got a whole plethora of ways that you can attach this to your vehicle. Let's take a look a little bit further. So you can see here, these were the things that I was latching in before. Got this nice and tight in here. These are really, really high quality and very, very nice. Again, this is all nice and thick, very, very thick ripstop. Now, this is what I was talking about before. This is the extra stuff. When you're looking at premium type of offerings, it has a built-in carabiner and it's got a built-in latch system here into the pole. So these aren't gonna come off if the wind blows. This pole is not gonna magically fly down. Again, we've got more stuff here. If we did have a lot of wind, we could either hook on some moon walls if we just wanted some extra shade, or we could actually put in some guy lines. In the middle, just like the rest of the quality, I've got this right here. I'm gonna actually hook a lamp into this in a bit, but this is built in. It's not something you have to do. Everything's in here. Now, I am 6'1", and I have plenty of room in here. We got plenty of cooktop space down here. This is gonna be ideal. I'm looking out at my campsite. Everybody's gonna be here in a bit, and this is gonna be the center of attention, is gonna be the Moon Shade. Can't say enough about how I am as excited about this as a product I've had in a while. Again, I partnered with Moon. There is a link in the description to give you $30 off. So go ahead and click that and get started. This is the Moon Shade from Moon Fab. It is absolutely awesome. It is the Rolls Royce of portable awnings. So go ahead and click on that link. Go ahead and get yourself some stuff. Hey, again, if you like these kind of videos, go ahead and click that like button. Don't forget to hit subscribe and click that bell to be notified when we got new content available. Thanks for everybody's time, and I hope you enjoyed the beautiful backdrop of the Chattahoochee National Forest.